Welcome to Rajiv Rao Accounts. Today's topic is trial balance. Because your exams are fast approaching, now I am explaining you trial balance today. Then tomorrow I will be taking, in other words, tomorrow I am going to upload the final accounts there. So in the coming some 1 week, I wanted to make you perfect with the final accounts. So please be in touch with my particular videos there, so that it will become easier for you to handle the paper. So let's discuss regarding the trial balance without wasting much of our time. So what is the trial balance, why it is being prepared? See, the meaning of this trial balance is something like this. Normally in the accounting cycle, what happens means, yearly, in the right from the beginning when the transaction takes place, it will be recorded in a chronological order in the book of original entry. It is nothing but the ledger. Then after that, it will be posted into ledger accounts. Okay, because the ledger is the book of second entry, wherein some different ledgers accounts will be maintained. So these entries will be posted into ledger accounts. Now at the end of the year, before preparing the trial balance or at any particular point of time there, if the businessman wants to check it, whether in the books of accounts whatever he has recorded, whether he has recorded it correctly or not, okay, in other words, the debits and the credit amounts, if he has recorded it correctly or not, to check it, he will be preparing this particular statement. Because you see, we are following double entry bookkeeping there. So under double entry bookkeeping, for every debit we will be having a corresponding credit and vice versa. So at any point, if we observe, the total debits in the books should be equal to that of the total credits there. So to check it up, whether in the books of accounts the total debits and the total credits are equal or not. Okay, they will be equal if we record it correctly. So to check that particular one, he will be preparing this particular statement called as trial balance. Okay, so normally this trial balance will be prepared at the end of the year, normally before preparing the final accounts there, before preparing financial statements, they will be preparing this trial balance. So let's see in the textbook there what a debit, what meanings they have said about this particular one. See, trial balance, the meaning, if you observe, it is a statement. So trial balance is not an account, it is a statement. Okay, a statement is something which gives some particular information. Okay, it gives statements there. So trial balance is a statement which shows either the balance or total amounts of the debit items and the credit items of all the accounts in the ledger. That means in the ledger, it will give the balances of all debits as well as all credits, or it will give the details about all debit items and credit items which are recorded in the ledger along with cash and bank balances. So totally in our books, since we are following the double entry bookkeeping, the total debits should be equal to that of the total credits. So see, after balancing all the ledger accounts, every account will be showing some balance there. So an account will be showing either debit balance or credit balance. So ultimately, if we see at the end there, when we are preparing trial balance, if you observe at any point of time, the total debit balances should be equal to total credit balances. So if they are equal, it means that we have recorded in the books of accounts, that means arithmetically, the debits and credit amounts are recorded correctly in the books of accounts there. That's what it asserts there. So observe here, trial balance, it is a statement which is being prepared. It is prepared on a particular date there. Okay, it is not prepared for one particular period. In other words, we can say, we should not say that trial balance is prepared for 1 year or for 6 months or for 1 month, it is like that. So it is prepared as on a particular date, to ascertain as on that date, till that particular date. Okay, whether the total debits and credits in the books of accounts are equal or not, to check that particular one. Okay, this statement is prepared. So the objectives of preparing this trial balance is nothing but to ascertain the arithmetical accuracy of the ledger accounts. Arithmetical accuracy means, figuratively, how correctly the debits and credits are recorded in the books of accounts, to check that particular one, trial balance is prepared. There is one particular objective. Then, to help in location of errors, that means in the books of accounts while recording or somewhere, okay, right from the beginning, right from the time we are recording in the journal there by way of an entry, till we prepare this particular statement, at one particular point of the time or the other, we might have committed some particular mistakes there. So, those particular mistakes will call it as errors. Okay, see. Errors are mistakes committed unknowingly, they are called as errors. So to locate those particular errors, because you see, if the total debits and credits, if they are not equal when we prepare a trial balance, okay, if there is no, in other words, some particular difference is there between the debit amounts and the credit amounts in that aggregate, okay, in the total at the end, it means that in the books of accounts somewhere we have committed some error. So if we will be able to locate that error, we will be able to rectify that particular error. So there is one particular objective. Then to facilitate the preparation of financial statements. See, financial statements are nothing but here, normally you will call it as a final account here. So, statement, financial statements are nothing but these are the statements which are prepared at the end of one particular period, accounting period. to give about the financial information. Okay, just like your trading account, profit and loss account, balance sheet, all these comes under financial statements only. So each one is prepared with one particular objective, because after this topic we'll be taking up financial statements only. There I will explain in the tomorrow in my video, I will be explaining regarding that particular one. So today simply you understand here, to prepare this particular financial statements, in other words to facilitate the preparation of financial statements with accuracy, okay, we are before preparing financial statements, normally this trial balance will be preparing to check up the whether arithmetically the debits and credits are equal or not. So that's one objective. Then see normally how it is being prepared. Okay, after this particular explanation I will give you one particular problem we will be taking up. I will show how to prepare the trial balance. Okay, because in the examination for BCom students, you may get it as a short question also, preparation of one trial balance. So it is very, very simple, very easy to understand. I will explain you. After this one, we will be taking up that one. See, before going into that one, if you see what are the limitations of this trial balance. See, tallied trial balance, that means if trial balance is tallied, that means the debit as well as the credit amounts in the trial balance, if they have tallied, okay, is not a conclusive proof of the accuracy of the books of account. In other words, if debits and credits if they have tallied, it is not a conclusive proof that everything recorded in the books of account is correct. There might be some particular errors there. Okay, in other words, here, even if the trial balance has a tallied there, some errors might be there in the books of accounts there. In other words, here simply we should not come to the conclusion that since trial balance is tallied, there are no errors in the books. Okay, so what are those errors which are not disclosed by the trial balance? That means trial balance will agree. Debits and credit amounts will agree. But the some errors will be there. What are those errors which are not disclosed by this trial balance? See, first one, error of principle. Error of principle is nothing but accounting principles are not followed there, and if the error is being committed in the books there. Just like a capital expenditure is required as a revenue expenditure, or a revenue expenditure is required as a capital expenditure, such type of errors will not be disclosed by the trial balance. That means trial balance will tally, but the error will be there in the books. Similarly, compensating errors. What is the meaning of compensating errors? In other words, here, to compensate one error committed, okay, if another error is being committed, it is called as compensating errors. Okay, so such type of errors also will not be located by the trial balance, because trial balance will tally there. Similarly, errors of complete omission. Complete omission means if a transaction is altogether omitted to be recorded in the books of account, okay, altogether or partially. In other words, neither the debit you have recorded nor the credit you have recorded. Such type of errors are also not disclosed by the trial balance. Trial balance will automatically tally. Then similarly, errors of recording in the books of original entry, then posting a correct amount in the wrong account but on the correct side. That means one correct amount you have posted, amount you have posted correctly, but where you are posted in the wrong account, that means instead of debiting to one account, you might have debited in another account. Instead of creating in one account, it will be created in a certain other account. Such type of errors also will not be disclosed, because ultimately debits and credits it will tally there. Okay, so how we should prepare the trial balance? Let's take one simple problem, then you will be understanding it how to do it. See, before going into preparation of trial balance, simply here you people should be able to know. Okay, I want you people to observe this particular one. When we prepare a ledger account, or any account, if you balance it, take for example two accounts. Okay, this is debit credit if you take it. Some account, I am not naming that particular account. When you balance it at the end there like this, if it comes by balance carried down, okay, it will be two balance brought down. Debit totals, you have totaled it, the total is more here, you have taken it here from this whatever items are there that you have subtracted, you got the balance amount here, by balance carried down, it will become two balance brought down. Now here you should get an idea which balance this particular account is showing. This is the debit side, this is the credit side if you take. Which balance this account is showing means you will decide over saying that this account will show, she is showing debit balance, because by two balance brought down, which side it is being brought down, it has come on the debit side. Okay, this is the debit side. So this account is showing debit balance. Similarly, if you balance one particular account and if you get two balance carried down, which will be writing by balance brought down, that means this account is showing which balance, it is showing credit balance. Got it? Now here every account student should have the certainty saying that so and so account should show so and so balance only. Okay, so basically you should have the particular idea which account should show debit balance, which account should show credit balance. Just like this account is showing debit balance, this account is showing credit balance. So what are those accounts which should show, which will show debit balance? What accounts are there which should show credit balance? Okay, simple concept I will tell you, listen here. See, already we have discussed about this particular one in the earlier classes, just like expenses. Okay, that means all accounts relating to expenses, just like salaries account, okay, wages account, carriage account, okay, purchases account. So this type of all expenses accounts should show which balance? Debit balance. They should show debit balance. Similarly, all losses accounts, that means accounts representing all losses, they will be showing debit balance only, just like your bad debts account. Okay, depreciation account, depreciation is nothing but it is an expense, so debit balance will be showing. Okay, so all expenses, losses, and all asset accounts, that means any particular account on the name of the asset, just like machinery account, furniture account, okay, building account, okay, cash account, all these are assets there. So any particular asset account, it should show debit balance only. Okay, so this is the basic concept you people should have in your mind. All accounts relating to the top expenses, losses, assets, they will be showing and they should show debit balance only. Similarly, accounts relating to incomes there, that means all income accounts, then similarly all gain accounts, okay, then again all liabilities accounts, these should show credit balance. Okay, just like interest received account, it is an income, it should show credit balance, by balance brought down, opening balance will be by balance brought down only. Similarly, rent received account, okay, similarly any particular liability you take, just like a creditors account, capital account, reserves account, any reserve for that matter, bills payable account, outstanding expenses account. So this type of all liabilities accounts, they will be showing credit balances. So this particular concept should be very much, it should be there in your mind. What accounts will show debit balance, what accounts should show debit balance, what accounts should show credit balance. If you are having this particular grip, okay, perfectly you will be able to handle the subject there. Take this particular problem there. I have written the problem here only on the board so that it will be easy for you to understand the problem there. See this particular problem there. What he has done, what he has asked us to do here. Prepare a trial balance from the following ledger balances on 31st December 2013. That means he is asking us to prepare a trial balance taking these balances on 31st December 2013. So trial balance format, you can draw something like this. Just like serial number, then name of the account there, then again debit amounts, credit amounts, we are going to list it out in these respective columns there. Now observe here. See, by seeing each particular account, now you should be able to identify, that's what I have said, what accounts will show debit balance, what accounts will show credit balance. Now try to analyze and check it. Even if you follow this one problem there carefully, a problem given on trial balance, easily you will be able to handle. Now you check it here. See, just like freehold land, he said, okay, serial number 1, first account, freehold land, okay, write down freehold land, freehold land. Now analyze, what is freehold land? Freehold land, is it an expense, income, loss, gain, asset, liability, what it is? Freehold land is an asset there. Since it is an asset, asset should show which balance? Debit balance. So this 70,000, you are going to write it here in the debit column, 70,000. Okay, that means even if an account, you are supposed to draw a freehold land account, you will be writing two balance brought down and you will be writing 70,000 on the debit side. The meaning is that one. Similarly, mortgage loan. Mortgage loan means here, loan taken by mortgaging one of your asset there. Okay, mortgaging means you have kept some of your asset as security to take a loan. So you have taken a loan by keeping some asset as security. It is a mortgage loan. Okay, so there is nothing but mortgage loan means, since your business has taken the loan, it is a liability to your business. Liabilities will show which balance? Credit balance. So second one, mortgage loan. So simply you are writing the name of the account here. Mortgage loan is showing a liability, means credit balance it should show. So 40,000, write it in the credit column. Then similarly, loose tools. Okay, loose tools. What are loose tools here? Loose tools means here, these are tools which are, in other words, small hammers, spanners, this type of tools, whatever you are having it, they are loose tools. సో లూజ్ టూల్స్ తెలుగులో విడిపని ముట్లు అంటారు మనం. ఓకే, సో దీస్ ఆర్ నథింగ్ బట్ దే ఆర్ అవర్ అసెట్స్ దేర్. సిన్స్ దే ఆర్ అవర్ అసెట్స్ దేర్, దే షుడ్ షో విచ్ బ్యాలెన్స్, డెబిట్ బ్యాలెన్స్. సో 11,200. నెక్స్ట్ బిల్స్ పేయబుల్. సి బిల్స్ పేయబుల్. Bills payable is nothing but these are those bills on which we are our business is supposed to pay. So it is a liability to us. So it should show which balance. Bills payable is a liability. So it should show credit balance. Liabilities will show credit balance. Similarly, sales. Okay, sales. What are sales to your business? Sales means sale of goods. If you have sold it, you will be earning an income. So since it is an income, income should show which balance? They should show credit balance. So in the credit column, 2,43,000. Okay, sales are incomes, so as such will show credit balance. Creditors, what are creditors? Creditors are nothing but these are the monies which our business owes to outsiders. Okay, that means it's a liability to us. Creditors, so creditors, since it's a liability, it should show which balance? Credit balance, 31,200. See, next, plant and machinery. So plant and machinery, what is it to the business? Plant and machinery is a asset to the business. Since it is an asset, which balance it should show? It should show debit balance. Assets will show debit balance. 91,000. Then again, debtors. Okay, debtors are nothing but debtors are the people who owes money to our business. They are the people who are supposed to pay money to our business. So this is the money which our business is supposed to receive. So it is our asset. So debtors are assets. Assets will show which balance? Debit balance. So 36,400 in the debit column you are writing it. Then similarly, cash at a bank. See, cash at a bank. Cash at a bank is nothing but here your particular business money which is there in the bank account. It is your money. So it will be showing debit balance since it is an asset to you. So debit balance 22,000. Next, stock. Stock is nothing but it is the amount of goods left over at a particular point of time in the business is a stock. It is an asset. So since it is an asset, it should show debit balance only. Then again, insurance. Insurance means here, this is nothing but here, the amount which is being paid as a premium to insurance company for the insurance policy taken by the business. It is the expense to the business. So expenses should show which balance? Debit balance. So in the debit column, then discount received. Observe here, discount received. Our business has received the discount. It is an income to it. Since it is an income, it should show which balance? It should show credit balance. 5,350. Then similarly, bad debts. Okay, what are bad debts? Bad debts are nothing but debts which are irrecoverable. Debt is the amount due from the debtor. If it has become irrecoverable, then you require it as a bad debt. What is it to our business? It is a loss. Since it is a loss, it should show which balance? Debit balance, 6,120. Then similarly, bills receivable. Check it, bills receivable. Bills receivable is nothing but these are those bills on which our business is supposed to receive the money. It is our asset to the business. So it is 6,120. Okay, bills receivable, 6,120. Sorry, this amount is wrongly written. This bills receivable is nothing but not 6,120. The amount is 10,800 here. So that 10,800, let's write it here. 10,800. Okay, it is an asset there, bills receivable. Then again, purchases. Okay, what are purchases here? Purchases are purchase of goods are called as purchases there. So purchases. Okay. Since they are purchased, these are the expenses incurred for the business. Expenses will show which balance? Debit balance they should show. Okay, so 1 lakh. We will be debiting it here, 1 lakh. Okay, then again, cash in hand. What is cash in hand? Cash in hand is nothing but the cash which is there in the business. Okay, it is our asset. So since it is an asset, it should show debit balance, 1,280. Then similarly, rent and rates. Okay. Rent and rates are nothing but here the rent which the business has paid, business is supposed to pay. In other words, it has paid it. It is an expense for the business. So 3,120. Then again, wages. Wages are nothing but what are wages? Wages are the monies which are paid to the casual labor. Okay, temporary labor. So it is an expense to the business.
So since it is an expense, we should debit it here, 21,400. Then again, trade expenses. Observe what he said, trade expenses, he said. Since they are expenses, they should show which balance? Debit balance, 2050. Then again, salaries. Salaries are nothing but these are the money paid to the permanent staff. Okay, they are the remuneration paid to the permanent staff. It is an expense to the business. So it should show debit balance, 3120. Then carriage inwards. Okay, carriage inwards. Okay, carriage inwards should show which balance? Carriage inwards are nothing but expenses incurred to bring the goods to your particular place. It is an expense. As such, we should debit. Then this is discount. Discount means here, which is this particular discount? Simply when he said a discount, it is a discount allowed. It is an expenditure. So, debit 580. Then similarly, capital. Okay, what is capital? Okay, I am not having a place here. So, okay. Capital, if you write it here, capital is nothing but it is a liability. So, liability should show which balance? Credit balance, 75,000. Now, if you total up these two, the debit totals, credit totals, okay? You should total, when you total it, if they agree, if they tally, that means there are no errors according to the trial balance. So, that is the purpose behind preparing. So, if you total it up, the total of the debit total comes up to 4,01,350. Similarly, credit total also comes up to 4,01,350. Okay? That means the debit total, credit total, if you individually, separately, if you total it up, both the totals will tally, the total is 4,01,350, both sides. So, it is agreeing. In other words, here, trial balance has tallied, we can say. Got it? Sometimes what happens means here, see, just like if it has tallied like this, then too some errors may remain. So, those errors which are not disclosed by the trial balance, earlier I have explained to you. Now, observe, sometimes what happens means, when we balance it, this debit total, credit total, they may not tally. Okay, some difference may come. Sometimes it will come. If it comes, it means that there are some errors. So, at that time, for the temporary purpose, what will you do here is, you will try to balance this particular trial balance there. So, wherever you fall short on debit side or on credit side. Okay, just like on debit side, the total is this much. Credit side, we are falling short of some 75,000 rupees. At that time, to tally it, you will write 75,000 here. Okay, on the credit side, wherever you fall short, the credit side or on the debit side, then you will write to one particular account called as suspense account. So, a question may be asked to you, what is a suspense account? At that time, simply you should be able to tell that suspense account is a account which is opened temporarily in order to balance the trial balance. Okay, in other words, simply here we can say we cannot specify clearly what is the nature of the suspense account, whether it is a personal, real or nominal. Because there are some particular errors in the books there, trial balance has not agreed. Okay, as such, for the time being, that particular difference, whatever we are getting it, we are transferring to that suspense account. So, when all the errors, when we detect it and when we rectify it, this suspense account will get closer there. So, that's what you should try to explain it regarding suspense account. I hope you people have followed this. Okay, you may get a short question on this particular one. Please go through this. While doing the final accounts also, for every problem, when he gives the trial balance, simply observe which particular account is showing which balance, in which column he has given. Easily, you will be able to get it. The way of preparing trial balance is something like this. Okay, I hope you people have followed it. Please do subscribe my channel. Please do share it. Okay, till the examination date there, in other words, in the coming 1 week there, continuously I will be keeping up the problems for you people, final accounts problems. So please do be in touch with me. Do subscribe. Do share it.